Located at the School of Visual Arts in New York City, the SVA RISO Lab was founded as an interdisciplinary space for printing, publishing, and the production of risograph-based works. Their mission is to be a hub of small-scale and experimental publishing activity, bringing together artists of all disciplines to encourage dialogue across different creative worlds. They offer continuing education courses and an undergraduate course, as well as public workshops, events, and an artist-in-residence program.
The MFA Visual Narrative Program is probably the first of its kind in visual storytelling that is interdisciplinary and low residency. So when we started, the challenge was really trying to define a program that would offer up a universal approach to what story is by putting story first, regardless of medium and approach. And a vast majority of our students are graphic artists. When we started the program in 2013, I was really trying to find a way to help my students facilitate self-publishing. And looking around the school, the one thing the school did not have, which as a comic book artist and an illustrator, I was already aware of, was access to efficient, automated, vibrant color reproduction. I knew of RISO and realized that the school didn't have any facilities like that or access to it. So I was like, aha, what might be possible? We launched in 2015, just within the program, and the school is gracious enough to run an experiment and test it here on campus, and it just has bloomed and blossomed from that point on. We now have 10 colors and 3 2-color machines.
We do everything from 3-hour workshops to 9-hour boot camps to, I also teach semester-long classes where we're doing 15 3-hour classes, and every week we're meeting and we're printing, and it really kind of depends on how intricate your design is and what you're really trying to do, because you can learn how to use a RISO in 10 minutes, if you want to do something basic. But to learn how to make, work that's more complicated, where you really want to push the technology, that can take, that can take years to really master. But that's more about how do you use the machine to get closer to what you have in mind. For making ephemeral art objects, zines, things, posters and things like that, it's just really efficient in a lot of ways. With RISO printing, you can make an edition of 100 or 200 books with the quality of a fine art print edition that looks like it was printed in a traditional print shop for almost no time and very little money. In teaching risograph printing, I find that it's a great tool to teach people about printing in general, because it kind of combines a lot of different forms of printmaking, so screen printing, offset printing. A lot of the planning you have to do for both of these different kinds of printing can go into RISO printing. But it's also an excuse to talk about color and sort of technical stuff like setting up files. But also, what does it mean? Why would you want to make a print, in this day and age? And what's the power of print? And what does it mean to make a print instead of a website and really committing to printing it on paper and using those resources?
I'm actually from an animation background, but I got interested in making comics, and I think RISO is really great for making comics. This is my first self-published comic, and I got a lot of support from MFA Visual Narrative, from the RISO Lab Thesis Publishing Fellowship, and it's really amazing because the quality is so great. It's way better than a Xerox printer, but it prints so quickly, so it's a great way to make a bunch of copies of comics and able to like spread your work around.
I've done other printing methods, so I've tried silkscreen, which also has a unique quality to it because you'll mix all your own colors, but it's messy and lengthy as a process. Like you'll have to set up your screen and then let it dry and then burn the image and then rinse it out, and it's this whole long, like 6-hour endeavor. But if I have my files ready and I show up here and I know exactly what I'm doing, I can be in and out of the studio in like an hour.
It's a valuable tool to the art community because it's so accessible, because you can experiment with it so much. With screen printing, you have to burn the screen and like use emulsion, and you have to do a whole darkroom, and there's no quick edits. And with RISO, you can say like, oh, you know what? I actually didn't want to use red. Let's try orange this time. And the masters, the screens aren't as expensive. There's just a lot more experimenting with printed matter that you can do with these machines. And that's, I think, really valuable to be able to have something tangible, especially like people that are just starting to print their work, seeing their work printed beautifully, a turn of the century print is so exciting and like encouraging to make new work and to experiment more with this printing process. And because I have control over like the production, I really like being able to see what I've made like real, tangible. My work is finally like, you know, not only on a computer anymore, it's, you know, something I can really feel, and you can see the grain and the texture, and have like kind of a relationship with your art in a different way.
The first week I was artist in residence, I realized that I could do something quite different than I had anticipated, to take a print form and turn it into a piece of sculpture. So my concept was to take the print media into the world of sculpture. So I've printed the fronts and backs. I've used a lot of cutouts. And this is actually a very small object, but the original piece was over 500 different sections, and it all fit together and built up into a giant, what looked like a kind of a mini New York City within a gallery where I set it up. Whenever I get the press, I would get it, and I would just print like crazy, and then I'd go home and start cutting out and folding. So hour-wise, it was several hundred hours, or maybe 1,000 hours, I'm not sure. I worked a lot day and night to get the whole thing together. But the big thing was, it was a total surprise once I got the whole thing together, and to see this massive set of prints that became a piece of sculpture was a real thrill. And you know, when I got the whole thing together, it looked like it was made of candy. The colors were so brilliant. They almost looked edible. It was a pretty delicious end to a really fun project.
As a design major, almost everything we do ends up being like a laser print, or even just like a really standard CMYK. Yeah. You design something on a computer and it looks one way when it's on a backlit screen. Yeah. And then once it comes out, it's just dull.
Yeah.
But with RISO, it's literally the opposite experience, where you'll design something and it comes out and it's like bright and punchy and saturated and like really unique to the way that RISO looks.
The colors just look amazing. And the fact that you can print with specific spot colors, like when you're printing with an orange, it's not going to be a mix of yellow and pink. It's going to be, you know, a pure orange or a pure green. So, you know, really just the speed, the efficiency, the beauty of the colors.
I also really like the texture, like the tactility of the way that ink sits on paper just feels really authentic and nice. And I like that I can make 50 copies of something and hand it out to every single one of my friends. And it just kind of makes this disposable, tradable, easy to circulate art.
It's like low commitment, but you get a lot of results.
The colors are insanely vibrant, and it is a really affordable, automated, multifaceted, and really dimensional medium and machine that can basically be played with. It's kind of been amazing to see the evolution of this thing, and I never really thought it was as accessible as it was. It was really amazing to see that transition happen, and this awesome experiment that's turned into the RISO Lab over the last 3 years, and really seems like it's only gonna grow and hopefully kind of fly and succeed.
Why do you choose to print with the RISO?
Because it's beautiful.